But this is a remarkable thing that's happened, that we're sitting here now doing this because of the show, which is a remarkable show. And it's this lightning in a bottle situation.
Yeah.
So then you leave.
Yeah.
How do you mentally get geared up for your next thing?
It was difficult for a very long time because I couldn't help but think that things went south for me, that it was my fault, that it wasn't good enough. So that if I was good at what I did and if I was better, that I wouldn't have had to leave. So when I went on to try to do new things, suddenly things didn't come as easily to me. I questioned myself more. Still do. Always worried, you know, it's such a special thing. It's such an amazingly special thing. There's like, it seems like there's no way it could ever happen again. So it took a long time for me to kind of like find the strength to move on to other things. And to try to do new things and create new things. And it's been tough, you know. I was hopeful for Super Best Friends Forever and that didn't work out. And I'm hopeful for Medusa and we'll see how that pans out in the long run. But I don't want to be like totally depressing, but I also want to be honest.
Yeah.
It has been hard. I think maybe other people might have bounced back better than I have. And unfortunately, that sets you up for heartbreak. Because this is a business and it needs to make money. And you know, there's other people who have their ideas about what's profitable and what isn't. And it's especially when you're making stuff for girls, it's just a constant battle. So I feel like I have a unique voice. And I'm just trying to find the best outlet to get it out there as uncompromised as possible. So it's still a journey for me. I'm still hoping to find my place where I get to tell my story in its entirety. So, I don't want to be depressing. I know it disappoints people to hear if, you know, that I'm not.
Deal with it, you guys.
But, you know, that's, I'm still struggling. If I'm being perfectly honest, just struggling. It's been a hard road.
Well, okay, so you said something to me when we had dinner that blew my mind. I mean, it still blows my mind. So my question to you, and feel free to veto this.
Okay. I'm drinking, I don't...
You want me to
veto when I'm drinking?
Should I go with my pipsqueak question instead, or...
Oh, I don't know, whichever one you want.
Okay. Pipsqueak. What is your impression of their impression of you?
Well...
No, there's a very specific reason I'm asking this. She has an incredibly skewed idea of what you guys think of her.
Well, you know, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and answer.
Do it, truthfully.
Because I think it what I just said was bad enough. you know, I feel like you don't miss me.
Aww.
Right?
Difference between the shows I worked on and the shows I didn't work on, and that all that work really wasn't worth it.
I'm trying to tell you, crazy, you don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
But she's
hard.
Yeah.
Indispensable person on this entire thing. This is all your thing.
I
know that.
It's hard, you guys. It's like it's, you know, but he likes it just the same.
No.
So let's talk about season 5.
Yeah, well that's part of it. That's part of what I talked, you know, was talking about.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Do you believe that?
I believe it. After that.